you want to introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Anne, Chief Roaster. I'm the boss. I'm the boss.
She thinks she's the boss. I'm Chris, the real boss.
This is Johnny.
I'm Johnny.
He sometimes thinks he's the boss.
I am the boss.
This one definitely thinks he's the boss.
Yeah, I'm definitely the boss.
And Ailey just brilliant. Ailey just smiles all the time.
Ailey really is the boss.
Yeah.
Well, she knows what's
and
going on.
And it's great to see Matt here. So it's the seed of a small fruit we call a coffee cherry, and usually you get two halves, like a peanut, growing inside a small round fruit that when they're ripe they're red. That's a complete coffee cherry, but that's a dry one, it's all brown. And if you were to break that open you'll find two little seeds inside. If you look at all those beans, they're all sorts of shapes and sizes and colours, and they're just different varieties really.
Oh wow.
They're all Arabica coffee beans, but they're all different from different regions and they're different varieties as well.
It's quite pea-like, quite fresh the smell.
Okay.
Oh, wow, nothing coffee about that at all. Yeah. So we store all the green beans next door in sacks.
Hello.
They still come in those sacks.
Are you
then we bring them in here for roasting.
Yeah, days off again.
Yeah, natural state. So it's basically coffee goes in there, the green beans, roasting drum, a little viewing, and that's the sample. So that's the sample of the roast of the green beans as they go in. So that's where the hand roasting comes into it. So exactly what stage the beans are at in the roast. And then when they're roasted, we let the beans out there into the cooling tray. So we've got two basic parameters of time and temperature. They're all different, they all roast to a different profile for different origins. They are two German roasters, and that's a little Turkish one in the corner. So bizarrely, although that's a more primitive compared to these, there's still some coffee that roast better than that. So you can have a go on and change?
Yeah, sure.
So
I've
got a single shot latte for that, so I'll show you how to do it. It's hard, you know, you sometimes.
You're not a drummer, are you?
No.
That could be good.
That could be good.
Shall I take this off?
Yeah.
Just a quick job, isn't it? Nice to drum, eh?
Yeah. Okay.
On
with
you?
No.
Push it into the other button, that's a button. You can't really do it, so it would be set, you can set it, but we haven't got it set.
This is different with all the coffee, so that's about, yeah.
Why you don't set it on the grinder? You see, it's quite heavy.
Yeah. So push down on it, as far as you can pull it down. We've got to make sure it's level.
Oh yeah, that's a good tip.
Yeah, fine, just go up on the top like that.
Your machine at home, Matt, will be in powerful of that, and it'll be easier for you. It's just really, the steam on there is quite powerful.
Okay, so the last one up here is just the middle one. Yeah, just press that, press it again. I'll put it on. Do you want to make a single shot or a
single
shot? Let's
do a
single. Single beat, put it at the bottom. Put a cup under there, just one size. Chuck that away if it's been heated already. Pour in about up to there-ish.
About
there. It's a little bit wrong.
Is that
too much? A little bit more. You don't actually need that much milk, but in these jugs, a bit more, it makes it easier to froth.
That's good.
Although you then waste a little bit. So this is just full on off. So I'm going to get it placed under, just going to hold it. I find the best way to do it, you hold it with in the handle and you keep one hand on there, then you feel it. Feel the temperature. When it gets too hot to touch, then turn it off.
Okay.
Maybe a little bit lower.
No, a little bit lower.
Yeah.
Maybe a little bit of oil. Yeah. 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 Oh, up a little bit.
And then it's fine.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
My day's
not
right.
And that's how you do it?
Yeah.
You give it a little knock on the table, it'll get a little swirl around, get rid of any bubbles. That's good milk.
Oh, thanks, man.
I'm nervous. So, start off kind of high ish, not too high. About that. Reasonably quickly, and then when you want to start doing the latte, go as close as you can without actually touching the coffee. It's all in the wrist, slow wiggle, and then when it's, you go back a bit, when it's done, pull up a little bit and go slow.
It's a lot of information. Here we go. Here goes nothing.
Right, so then you want to pour a little bit faster to get goes a bit closer. You're getting something.
Look at that. That looks like a butterfly to me.
Yeah, it does.
Oh,
yeah.
I'm good at this. No, I'm not. This is terrible.
I bet you've done this
a few times. Yeah,
it's wicked. That's amazing. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I really appreciate my lesson. Thank you so much.
And I'll let you guys know how good this tastes.